Thank you for plugging into this Family Life News podcast, streaming issues-driven, family-focused news.
Welcome back to another edition of Capital Connection. Fridays during the Noon Report, we give you, the listener, direct connection to what's happening in Albany and Harrisburg with the experts on the issues at the state capitals. They are Jason McGuire with New Yorkers for Constitutional Freedoms and Michael Geer at the Pennsylvania Family Institute. Well, gentlemen, it is so good to have you back on the program after a long summer break. There is much to discuss, and Jason, I want to begin with you. The migrant crisis is starting to get way too real for a whole lot of people. Over 100,000 new arrivals since last year. They're showing up in our hotels, in our schools. The governor wants work visas for these people. Do you think that is a good starting point, or will that only exacerbate this crisis?
You know, it's 100,000 have already come and no end in sight. And I think you're only going to exacerbate the problem if you go ahead and incentivize the same behavior. Until we do something to close the border, and that is a federal issue, I don't see how incentivizing things at the state level is really going to address this problem. It's only going to draw more migrants here. The other thing that I think is in the back of the mind people should be thinking about is New York City is already weighing legislation that will allow anybody who is a resident of the city, not a citizen, but a resident, to go ahead and vote after 30 days of residency. We're essentially on the cusp of now allowing non-citizens who have come here as asylum seekers to vote in city elections after only 30 days of living within the boroughs.
One quick follow-up. I know Rob Ort, the Senate Minority Leader, and Will Barclay, the Assembly Minority Leader, have called for a special session of the legislature to address this. Is there anything that the state can do to fix this problem or to right this ship?
Well, I think there has to be a unified approach to how we deal with this. And so crossing party lines, Republicans and Democrats have to put the politics of the 2024 election cycle aside and then pressure the Biden administration to finally take action on fixing the border crisis.
Well, school choice, a major issue this summer in Pennsylvania, Michael. It was dealt a big blow when the flip-flopping Governor Shapiro struck down this Lifeline scholarship program, says he still supports school choice, but won't put his money where his mouth is on this issue. If you would, Michael, what's the governor afraid of here? And do you think most Pennsylvanians support school choice?
Well, you know, Governor Shapiro's flip-flop and then line item veto of the Lifeline Scholarship Program, something that he said he was for and negotiated with the Senate Republicans to get in the budget. I think that veto is direct evidence of the power of the teachers union. That's who he's afraid of. I think polls do suggest increasing support for expanded parental choice in education. It's very popular. We're going to continue to push here at PA Family for expanded school choice and to try to hold the governor to account to what he said he was for when he ran for office. All he needed to do was sign the budget with it in it, and we think that he needs to turn face again.
Yep. We had Assemblyman Phil Palmisano of the Southern Tier on with us recently, Jason. When it comes to this whole effort at electrification, he said instead of ready, aim, fire, it's fire, aim, and we're still not ready. What are the real world consequences of this rush to eliminate fossil fuels in New York? And when does this start to get real for New Yorkers?
Well, I think the real world consequences is the collapse of our utilities. I mean, frankly, our system cannot handle the direction and the speed at which the state is trying to eliminate fossil fuels. If we do not rectify this problem and actually slow our pace, we're going to have some real problems in places where heat is required, some very cold temperatures come winter.
Yeah, couldn't believe this, Michael. For the first time in 30 years, Pennsylvania will be ending funding for real alternatives. This provides pro-life counseling to abortion-vulnerable women in Pennsylvania. The money runs dry December 31st. What are the consequences of this decision by Governor Shapiro?
Well, this decision by Governor Shapiro is evidence of the power of Planned Parenthood, another big campaign donor to Shapiro. That program to fund alternatives to abortion here in Pennsylvania was bipartisan from the start, with then-pro-life Governor Robert Casey starting it back in the early 1990s. And the consequences are really significant. If this move is allowed to stand, it will impact pregnancy resource centers that partially rely on this funding to meet the needs of the thousands of clients they see each year.
Yeah, and correct me if I'm wrong, I think there's something like 80 of these clinics across the Commonwealth. Will they just cease to exist after December 31st?
Hopefully not. Many of them are supported in addition with private funding that comes from folks like those listening to this program. And we encourage continued financial support and volunteers for pregnancy resource centers all across Pennsylvania.
Yeah, Jason, let's talk more about the abortion debate in New York State. Of course, no state is more abortion friendly than New York. How can pro-lifers start to get on the winning side of the abortion debate when it comes to outcomes in elections? We're already seeing how pro-choice America is planning to use the abortion debate in 2024, like they did in 2022, to retain their grip on power.
Well, if I could do one thing to help candidates in 2024, really two things. First would be to give them a spine, and the second would be to give them media training. You know, if they could recognize that we need people who will champion this cause, make that decision. I'm going to champion the cause of life. Start there. And then get media training. Learn how to winsomely and articulately talk about those issues. That could be all the difference. But too often we've seen the candidates that get the deer in the headlight looks when the abortion question comes up, and they try to scurry from the issue rather than answer it directly. Mm-hmm. We have the right issue. We have the right side of history. We have the right moral sense in this. And we have to go forward from that position and declare what is truth in this in a way that will win the culture. And nobody better than candidates in the bully pulpit to begin to talk about this in a winsome and articulate way.
Well said, Jason. Thank you. There was an op-ed in the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette, Michael. I think it was written by one of the people on your staff. It deals with saving women's sport. The author said, I didn't have to compete against males, and my daughter shouldn't have to either. Do you think that her daughter will at some point be forced into that boat, given the way we've seen the influence of the transgender movement grow in recent months and years?
Well, I'm hoping not, and I hope common sense ultimately wins and is victorious in all of this. That article you mentioned was written by our operations manager, Emily Krepps. She was a collegiate swimmer and has a young daughter, Sonia, and like every parent of a daughter, Emily intensely feels a concern about what is happening in our culture regarding personal privacy and girl sports, highlighted by the absolute unfairness of male Penn swimmer Leah, formerly William Thomas, competing against women and winning championships. You know, we've been fighting this fight here in Pennsylvania. You remember in the last session, we got a girls' sports bill passed, only to have it vetoed by Governor Wolf. So the fight right now here in Pennsylvania is in local school districts. A number of them, with our help, have enacted policies to protect girls' sports.
All right. Hey, we got about a minute left to go, but two really important issues, Jason. Regardless of your opinion on marijuana, the rollout of the cannabis marketplace in New York has been chaotic and cumbersome. Do you think this is further evidence of a road best left not traveled? Do you think the social and economic experiment here will backfire?
Yeah, I think it already is. It came with a promise of revenue and racial justice, and we're just not seeing this situation panning out. In fact, what I think we are seeing is increased use by people, the desensitization towards not only marijuana, but even other drugs, and just a culture as a state that is moving more and more towards that pro-drug position. We're raising the tax on a pack of cigarettes by a dollar because smoking is bad, while we have legislators bragging about buying their marijuana they could smoke on their Twitter feeds. Hmm. It just makes no sense. There's so much inconsistency in how we approach things.
And if anybody says this is not a problem, I encourage you to travel to New York City and just take a whiff of the air. It might change your mind. And then finally, Michael, Jim Gregory made news recently, Republican representative, I believe, from Blair County, his Protection of Minors from Unfiltered Devices Act. This is all in an effort to keep kids away from the harmful effects of pornography. Any chance that this passes?
I'm not sure whether it will bill passed. It's something that we do support because of the impact of pornography and obscenity on children. And with the ubiquitousness of porn on smartphones and tablets and all of those sorts of things, we applaud Representative Gregory for taking this action. Other states have looked at additional ways to deal with it. One of those is to install age restrictions where the ISPs and the providers have to confirm the age of the person who's viewing it. And that can be another helpful way to try to address the issue of porn.
All right. And just like that, our time is up. It's the fastest 10 minutes in radio, as we like to say here. And it's great to have both of you back on our air. If you have any questions about any of the issues discussed today, or if you simply want to know what is New Yorkers for Constitutional Freedoms anyway, Jason, you have a wonderful website. Where can folks go and check you out?
AlbanyUpdate.com.
Stay informed on all the issues as well in Pennsylvania. There are certainly a lot of them. Michael, what's your website, sir?
PAFamily.org.